Peggy 16.
Said, getting them off the ground is kind of an overlooked topic for a lot of new players, and generally the safest thing to do is the tech roll, where you're just going to hit either punches or kicks when you're on the ground. I'm going to let Mike talk about it all though, so Mike, take it away.
Alright, so to tech roll in this game, there's two different options to tech roll. You could either tech roll into the background or into the foreground, and the easy way to think about it is that your button map is your stage. So the top part is the background, and the bottom part is your foreground. So the top buttons are obviously 1 or 2, which is your punches, so that will tech roll you into the background, and the kicks will tech roll you into the foreground. So I'll give a small example here by knocking Lay down the launcher, and then he's going to tech roll that. He used punches to tech roll into the background. This one he's going to tech roll into the foreground, but using kicks. So you could use either of the buttons. You could just slide the buttons if you want to tech roll.
Right, and generally you want to roll away from a wall. Like, to make yourself distance, basically.
Yeah, you can also use tech rolls off the wall as well, so let's see. So you can tech roll off the wall as well, and it's the same idea as again. Generally, tech rolls are a safer option to get off the ground, and it is the quickest way. But there are things called tech traps as well that you have to look out for.
Right, but in general, you want to tech roll off the wall. But let's show them an example of where you wouldn't want to tech roll off the wall. You've got Brian in there. Brian has a taunt, which is an unblockable attack. So basically, after he hits his wall combo, if Lay player is going to tech, then Brian can actually hit his unblockable taunt on him. Okay, so that's a small example of a tech cat situation, but at the wall you can actually tech roll late as well, right? Do we want to show them that really quickly?
Yeah, you could delay your tech catch, your tech roll timing while you're still sliding down the wall.
Nice. Cool. So I think that about covers tech rolls, right? Let's go ahead and talk about side rolls and back rolls.
So basically, whenever you are spiked on the ground, like let's say I'm going to launch Lay here and then use a bind move and then a spike move to slam him down to the ground. In those situations, you cannot tech roll off the ground because you are slammed onto the ground. And the only situations you can tech roll are when you're thrown to the ground and, like, let's say something like this. He's still floating, and then he lands on the ground. I didn't slam him down to the ground, so he can tech roll in those situations. But when I slam him to the ground, we call that a spike. Those you can't tech roll, and you have other options instead. You have all these options all the time anyways, but it's just up to you if you want to use your tech roll right away or if you want to stay grounded. Another example of a hard knockdown in this game would be like throws. So throws you can't tech roll off of, except with certain few exceptions. Generally, throws are going to leave you in this state where you have to, you know, guess right away and you can't tech roll off of. So there is, the first thing I want to talk about is side rolling. To do a side roll, you press 1 and then that will side roll you into the background. And if you hold down after doing the side roll, you just continue to stay down on the ground. But keep in mind, you are only limited to one side roll while you're on the ground unless you get hit on the ground again. So he's trying to side roll again, he's mashing on 1, he can't do anything until I hit him on the ground. Oh, and also, you could also tech roll off the ground if you get hit again as well. So yeah, to hit him, you could, you know, tech roll right away, or you could choose to still stay grounded and then side roll again if you wanted to. Side roll again. And there is 4 basic grounded positions in this game. The most basic one is face up, feet towards. And these are usually acronymed by 4-letter acronyms by F, U, F, T.
Excuse me?
I'm sorry. That basically means face up, feet towards, or you can have face up, head towards, or what have you. And so this is basically the most general knockdown position that you'll have.
Yeah, let's go ahead and show the positions. And generally, the acronym is actually face up, feet something.
Yeah.
Right, those are the, you say basically where the face is and where the feet is.
Face down, yeah. Face up or down, or feet towards or feet away.
Right, and between those options, you have 4 combinations.
Yes.
Am I right here?
Yes.
Okay. Sounds about right.
So let's show them the 4 options, Bob.
All right. So we have your
face up, feet towards. You have your face down, feet towards. Face down, feet away. And you guessed it, face up, feet away.
Wow. And obviously there's only Lei that can do all these positions for us. You know, this isn't like something every character can
do.
This
is a convenience for
us. Yeah, it's convenient for us to show you this.
Thank you, Lei.
Right, so basically the way you're going to be left in those positions is if after certain combos you get spiked and then you're in that situation, or after maybe certain throws, they'll
leave
you in different
positions.
Yeah,
generally throws, you're left in like a hard knockdown position, so where you can't tap roll. Some throws you can, but those are very rare.
Yeah, and so kind of an advanced strategy if you're scared of how to get up against your opponent is to just take one another round and tap roll immediately. And this is generally the safest option you have.
Yeah, because generally if you back roll in certain situations, you can eat massive damage and you can get screwed.
Or like a rebound.
Yeah, right. Exactly. Well, let's just show a small, quick example here with Brian's one throw and what can happen if you back roll.
Oh!
Yeah, and then you can get into a combo and then what have you. You just lost like throw damage and a full combo on your back, so.
That's because you rolled.
Okay, so generally back rolling though is also a really bad option from any knockdown.
Yeah.
Right, because you can get picked up by like lots of things by every character basically. Mm-hmm. Every character has an option generally to pack back.
Even in situations where you can tech roll, if you choose to back roll afterwards, mm-hmm. you're left, even not when you're back turned as well, you could also eat a full combo. So let's say he back rolls, right there. I could time it so that he gets up, and the character actually gets up and crouching for a few frames.
Well, okay.
For a bit. So if I just get a full launcher again.
Right.
Well, yeah. Even when he's facing forwards.
Right. So let's show that exact same setup again and show Bob tech rolling instead.
Yeah. So right. Either it whiffs or he can block it and then I'm screwed.
Right.
In general. So.
Cool. And so, okay. So basically, those are the basic ways to get up off the ground. But we still haven't really shown them from the different positions which ones are dangerous and which ones aren't that dangerous.
Okay.
So let's go and show them that really.
Yeah, next thing we talk about, let's talk about how you can attack when you're on the grounded positions. We have low kick and mid kick. So threes are going to be your low kick. In any general rule of thumb, easy way to remember it, heads up is whenever your character's face up, your threes will not knock down unless they're counter hit. So let's just show it on normal hit. It doesn't get a combo, but on counter hit, let's show them getting a knockdown. On counter hit, they can follow up with a full combo, and boom. You know? So, but the mid kicks in general, they don't have any kind of benefits other than giving a knockdown on counter hit. And on normal hit, they just give you advantage. And that's it. But whenever your character's in face down position, keep in mind that all the low kicks will knock down on normal hit no matter what. Unless, in one exception where you're face down, feet away, if you're too far, it won't trip. Yeah, so only in clean hit situations where it's really deep.
Cool. So I think that covers pretty much all of the basics of getting up off the ground, yeah?
There's just one more, you know, there's like spring kicks and cross chops, and you know.
And how do you do those?
You could also do like combinations of side rolling then doing a low, you know, you could get yourself into these positions if you wanted to with every character whenever you're knocked down. So spring kick, this is pretty character specific. Characters have a different animation.
Right, Lei doesn't have it.
Yeah, so Brian, you know, is just back 3+4, or you can also do like back 1+2, and then do a cross chop. All these things are a different option and have their own benefits as well, and their own risks.
Right, and actually that just reminds me, there is actually
one more, it's a Chinese get up.
Oh yeah, well, okay, go on. I'll talk about something else. There's two more.
Okay, so I'm gonna knock Lei into the air with a jet upper, and then if he holds forward, instead of being able to tech roll, he could actually do, this is what we call a Chinese getup. You just hold forward and then they'll notice you'll do a quick little spring kick, and it also does a little bit of damage as well and it counts as a hit. So.
Yeah, in certain knockdown situations, people are going to do like something like a running three at you as Oki. This Chinese getup kick can actually float them for a little juggle as well.
Yes, that's correct. And but the only risky part is if he decides to do this and whiffs it, I could just launch him again. So. Just keep in mind about that option.
Yeah, and something new to this tag game actually is what they're calling, I think it's called quick tag roll, or tag quick roll, I forget. But basically in situations like say Brian's mock punch, on regular hit, you just get hit by a pop, you'll see that the legs go up in the air like that. These situations you can actually hold back and your character like, will quickly back roll out of it. So this will prevent any OP setup. Another option that's been added to this game is that you can hit tag instead of holding back. And I'll get a quick tag when your tag teammate will come into it instead.
All All right, so now we're gonna talk about running attacks. You can initiate this by tapping forward, forward, you know, dashing, and holding that forward direction. So if you run a few steps, you're gonna be able to tackle your opponent after about a few steps. After you tackle them, you have the option of punching them by either pushing the left punch or right punch buttons, which will allow you to gain additional damage.
Right, and new to this game is that you could actually do the same punch over and over again.
Right, you don't have to alternate. You can just push left punch, right punch, or you know, whatever combination.
And to break this punch away, if that person is doing a one, you actually have to press it by a two because they're punching you with your left hand and you're deflecting it with your right hand.
Exactly.
Right, so let's see that in action. There you go.
You
love
me!
Wow, first guess.
If you press two right at the beginning of the tackle, you'll actually push him to the side. If you press 1+2 right before they hit the ground, you actually flip them over
and then you can punch them.
And the tables have turned.
There you go, exactly. And certain characters after the tackle, they can initiate an arm break when they push 1+2. Then to defend against that, once they start that arm break, you can push 1+2 and then push 2-4 times to...
quick succession.
Yes.
Repeatedly. It's all in one motion. You can break that arm break.
Mm-hmm.
Before we move on, just one more thing, like some characters also have a reversal as well. Like Paul, Dragunov, when you're pressing 1-1-2, when they're about to punch you, mm-hmm. and they start off with either right or left punch, I'm not sure exactly which one, they'll actually reverse it and it'll get them in a reversal while they're on the ground. So basically what happened is that I did a right punch with JC here, and then Dragunov reversed it while he was in the tackle position. A couple characters have this, and it's completely character specific to those characters on it. So.
Cool. So Bob, let's go back to more than two steps.
So now we're going to go beyond two steps. Right. And you get a few more options out of it. You can either push 4 or 3 or 1+2, and you get some moves out of it. We'll have JC demonstrate those. So that is a running 3. It's like a generic running 3 that most of the cast has that as a generic move. That is the generic 4, which is a trip. So the running 3 is a mid, as well as that running 1+2, which is a cross chop.
Running cross chop.
And then you have one low option, which is the running 4.
Cool. So what about more than 3 steps, Bob?
But now let's show the ultimate, which is 4 steps.
Bum, bum, bum.
If you're able to be in this situation where you're on the complete other side of the screen, and hopefully the other character's not running at you first.
Or if you end a combo and they're back rolling as you're running at them.
Exactly. So especially in Tag Tournament 2, you're able to put your opponent in a situation where they're all on the other side of the screen and you can start running at them. But this is what it looks like. So if you do a dash and you hold forward, and if you run all the way, you get a shoulder charge, which is unblockable. And there's no way to block it, but you can't evade it.
Right, you can sidestep or sidewalk, but it's very late in the animation. Or you can even jump over them, but all of those things require extremely precise timing.
Some practice. So let's
see. Have you ever tried tagging out to avoid it? Like tagging at the right moment? That would be crazy.
Yeah, actually it works. Your first character tagging out will get hit, but your second character can punish him.
Oh, wow. Can we show that?
Yeah.
Oh.
Or completely avoid it.
Very nice, Mike.
So that's
very nice.
One way. But how about for solo characters? How would they avoid it?
You're screwed. you can actually sidestep it.
Yeah.
There you go. So you just gotta make sure.
Was that a sidestep or a sidewalk?
Oh, sidestep.
Perfect.
Okay. Really good. I'm pretty impressed with myself.
I think as you did it because you were in game mode instead of trying to show it, so it worked out pretty well. So it's not too hard, but it just takes some practice. But it is doable.
Mm-hmm.
So now we're gonna show some character specific running moves. So Dragunov has two special ones. He has a running 2 and a running 3. So here's a running 2, which is a mid punch. And he also has a running 3. Which is a slide. So it's good options when you're doing a run-in where you can actually mix up your opponent with those special tag moves or special running moves.
Right, but that running low can only be done after 3 steps, and it's not often that you're going to have that much space.
Right.
But so, something unique to this tag game is that you can do running attacks off of the tag game.
Exactly. So this will be very useful in situations where you're raw tagging and then bringing in a character and then you can force a mix-up basically.
Right, yeah. Especially a character that has a unique running attack.
Yeah, it is. Granted that you have enough time to safely tag in.
Right, and you can initiate that right when you push the tag button by pushing the 3 forwards and then mm-hmm. the button.
Yeah,
just
instead of like needing space for 3 steps, you could do this like right up in their face too, as long as you just press triple forward.
Yeah, so definitely a nice situation where you can use that move where you normally would be a very unique situation. So normally when you're in the middle of the screen and you tag in your character, he'll be able to run in and do some running attacks. But if you're at the wall, you lose that option because your character hops in as opposed to running him. And in those situations, you can't do any running attacks.
Right.
Your character just kind of jumps in. And so that's your only option at the wall. So that's a bit of a disadvantage if you're trying to do some running attacks, because again, only possible in the middle of the screen.
Cool.
All right, so there's another set of defensive options in this game, and we'll categorize them as reversals. So the first basic, most universal reversal in this game is called the low parry. So how do you do the low parry? You just tap down forward.
Right, we covered this in the first episode a little bit, so you guys already have a general idea of how this works. Mm-hmm. You just tap down forward, and opponent's doing a low attack.
And then you'll sweep their leg, and then you can't use your bind anymore. We'll get to the combo system in the next episode. But you generally use up your bind right away, and then you could go for a mini combo there, or what have you, you know, something like that. That's just an example. And then the next thing we'll go on to is
actual parries.
Yeah, sure, that sounds good to me. Wang actually has these are actually kind of character specific. Depends on the character. Some characters don't have parries at all. Some characters have moves that parry only in certain animations, like part of the animation, but those are called Tsubakis, which we'll get to.
Right. I mean, you also have Law on your team. You can show, I mean, Law has a parry that's only punches and kicks for highs and mids, but he also has a punch parry with just back 1+2 that's only punches.
Yep. And, you know, what good is a parry if you don't have a follow-up? So let's show Wang. His parry is back 1. And it actually parries multiple hits in succession. So if Bruce did like a string like 1-2-1-2, it'll parry the whole thing by itself.
Wang is awesome.
And all I did was press the parry button once. So basically what a parry is, it moves the move out of the way. It doesn't stop the other opponent's animation of the move. It lets them still do it. But Law's parry is a little different exception. It's kind of very specific to him. So. Yeah, it actually pushes him out of the way and stops their animation, but Law gets something guaranteed out of it.
Right.
So
and not all characters get something guaranteed after a parry.
Yes, that's true.
Like, I think Ling does not.
Yes, that's true.
Neither does Force Law.
And Jin, you know, he only gets it in big whiff situations.
Right.
So there goes that. So the next thing we're going to talk about is reversals. Reversals are kind of like what Law's parry looks like, but they're a little different. Why are they different? Because you can chicken them. That's what a reversal is.
Right, but generally also reversals, they actually catch the move.
Yeah, that's correct.
And they catch
the move, and they put them in like a throw-like animation.
Right.
So let's show, let's have Bob do a 1, then a 1 again. Oh no, I hurt your arm!
And here's a situation where it puts them, you know, face down, like feet away.
Right. Which you could get a combo from with a
little bit. Oh, but not too far away.
Nope, off axis as well.
All right. So there we go, that's a reversal, and there are some exceptions to this rule as well. So he can reverse also kicks as well, so that's happened to a 1 and a 3. Boom! Punch you in the mouth.
And right. Certain characters, their reversals are chickenable, and of them are not chickenable.
Yeah, that's correct.
So what's a chicken bone? It's one of those animals that are not, just kidding.
They're delicious when you put rotisserie in front of them. So.
The name rotisserie chicken.
Oh, I see. Got it.
Right. So, to chicken, like we said, Tekken is a game about lambs. 1, 2, 3, 4. We know our numbers.
Lambs.
So, chicken and lamb.
I'm hungry.
Right. I'm getting hungry.
All right.
But let's go back to the naming of chicken, okay? So back in Tekken 3, I think it was.
Yes.
When this chicken term that we're going to describe in a second would occur, the game would actually say chicken to you.
Chicken. And that was actually a glitch,
right,
if I remember correctly.
And because of that, the term has stuck around in the Tekken vocabulary. So Mike, why don't you go ahead and explain how to perform a chicken, and then that will teach Bob how to do it so he can demonstrate it to us.
All right, most definitely. So, like we talked about, Tekken is a game about limbs. Mm-hmm. So, let's say I reverse a left limb, left punch or a kick. So anything on the left side, you want to chicken it with a forward to push them away. Mm-hmm. Think of it as pushing them away, and both left attacks. So you're gonna be, if you sent out a left punch, you're gonna be pressing forward 1+3.
Right.
So if they're doing a right punch or a right kick, mm-hmm. you do it in reverse. Well, not really reverse.
Right.
Forward and 2+4 instead.
Right, the right limbs.
Yeah, the right limbs. So let's show a demonstration of that right now. So I'm gonna have Bruce do a 1 and a 3, and then Bob's gonna chicken it with a 4, 1+3.
Okay.
Chicken. I don't know if it said it because we don't have sound here. But yeah, chicken.
Chicken. Delicious. And we're going to show the same thing again with a right limb. And it's pretty much going to be the same animation, but it's going to just be with a different notation to chicken.
Oh!
There you go.
That's wow, Bob, chicken. You really leveled up your game today. That's quite impressive.
Well, I was 50% right.
Okay, so before we move on, there are certain types of moves in this game that you cannot chicken at all. I mean, reversal at all.
Mm-hmm.
So, an easy example is knees and elbows. So
and heads, if you're a Lisa. Just saying.
Yes, like so.
Or
like,
Fang.
Okay, all right. A lot of people have heads, I guess.
I think the entire cast has heads in this game.
Maybe.
So anyway, these heads, elbows, and knees are generally unreversible.
Yes, that's.
And generally unparryable by certain parries as well.
Yes.
So let's go ahead and show someone trying to counter one of these.
Yeah, let's. I don't have a counter.
Okay, so we're gonna have Bruce do a jab, and then I'm gonna have Bruce do a back two after it, and I'm gonna try to reverse that. No!
No!
So you eat a big knee to the face, and yeah, you should have one of that.
Right, but as I mentioned, Wang's parry can parry pretty much everything in the game. This, like one except I don't remember what it is. But let's go ahead and show that he can parry the Bruce's back two. Yeah. He can actually also parry the unblockable shoulder tackle I just found out. So Wang is parry is very special. It's, mm-hmm. It does a lot of stuff that a lot of other characters cannot do.
Yep. And I guess
Sabakis are something else we should cover.
We have Sabaki parries next. Mm-hmm. Sabaki parries are very weird.
Yeah, it's hard to describe. So I think the general description is supposed to be it's a parry with a built-in attack.
Yeah, that's correct. That's probably right. So I guess technically Wang has a Sabaki parry as well. With that move, it's kind of more like it kind of like absorbs attack. An attack.
There you go.
So yeah, as you saw right there, it completely absorbed the animation and he just went with the attack anyways. Kind of a bad example of a Sabaki parry, but luckily we still have Bruce on the screen, so we can show Sabaki parry with Bruce. Bruce's 442 is a high punch attack, but in certain parts of a move, he actually pushes aside a punch and cracks your neck. So it's,
and it sounds really cool when you have sound.
Ugh.
Oh gosh, man, you're good at that. Much better than that than chickens. Alright, so I think that about wraps up the reversal system of the game. We showed you low parries, parries, reversals, and Sabaki parries as well.
Yeah, of course some characters have a little here and there of different kind of parries and different kind of, you know, different situations and stuff. That's generally the basic three kinds of parries that you have in this kind of game. Or reversals.
Cool. So let's move on then and tell you in general how not to get owned in Tekken.
Block.
Alrighty, so in general, when you're a newbie, there's like a couple things that'll get you killed really easily. And in these first two episodes, we've kind of highlighted a lot of these things, and hopefully this is going to be a little summary of them. So number one, we want to safely backdash by hitting back and hold back. Okay, if, as long as you don't do backpack neutral, you won't be able to get hit in it. And number two, if you get knocked down, don't back roll. Back roll generally is going to be a problem. It's,
yeah.
When you don't know what's coming, generally you either want to take a hit and tech roll off the ground, or you can just tech roll before that, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
If tech roll is available.
Right. As we said, you know, spikes and throws generally be in positions where you aren't going to be able to tech roll. And going back to the first episode even, generally if you get hit by an attack, do not hit buttons again afterward or you're probably going to get launched. Right. See, so in that kind of a situation, you know, Lars got impatient, he tried to attack even though he was hit first, and he was at such a disadvantage that Law's gonna get a free launch on him.
Right.
And this one's gonna sound a little bit weird, but don't hit buttons.
What?
Yeah, I mean, this obviously
learn
favors
when to hit buttons.
Okay, fine. I guess that's a little nicer way to say it, right? But you have to basically learn the flow of a Tekken match, and that's kind of what we've been trying to show you these things, especially the first episode, second episode. And you basically have to pick your spots, you know, outzone your opponent, outspace your opponent, and basically find the openings to hit the buttons. Don't just go in there hitting buttons all day long or your opponent's gonna outspace you and basically get free damage on you.
Yeah, and also make sure if you're gonna try to attack them, make sure they at least connect. That's your main goal.
Yeah,
if you're gonna attack and you're planning on whiffing, you're just giving an opening to them.
A very big opening, generally.
Yeah.
So yeah, definitely learn the range of your moves and make sure that they connect, even if it's on block.
Yeah, and also when they're trying to attack you, try to make them whiff with your movement. That's generally what Tekken is. It's a movement-based game.
So. Yeah, I mean, we didn't really say the words before, but Tekken is very much a footsie-based game.
Yes.
So if you come from a 2D background, footsies is probably a big word for you or something that's important to your gameplay, and it's extra important in Tekken.
And one thing you were saying earlier about not pushing buttons, like it's okay to let your opponent attack you.
Right.
Because you block certain moves that are punishable, mm-hmm. you get free damage for not doing anything.
And there's no guard damage in this game either.
Right.
So, you know, you take those two things together and, you know, it kind of, I mean, that's kind of my philosophy behind Tekken, that I'm generally more of a turtle player. So that's kind of the way I've learned the game. But it doesn't mean that you have to learn the game that way as well. You know, you can learn to push buttons, but like Mike said, you got to learn when to push buttons and find the openings to push the buttons in.
Exactly.
So really briefly, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the tag crash system. Now, tag crash is an option where your teammate will come flying through the sky and it'll basically bring you in safely. So you can only do this when your partner's life bar is flashing, as you can see on the screen right now. Generally, this life bar will only be flashing when you've lost about half your life or more, depending on the allegiance of your characters. And to execute a tag crash, the notation is 2+5.
Just so, like attack throw.
Right, and you can only do it when your character is grounded. So Bruce, if you could just hop kick Wang real quick so he's grounded. So now when Wang is grounded here, if you wanted to get up off the ground, say you want to attack for whatever reason, he could attack, but his character can run out really slow like we showed you before. So perform a tag crash and basically stop Bruce's momentum, you would do 2+5 right here. And your character comes in from the sky. And generally this is a safe way to tag in, but if your opponent anticipates it, they can actually sidestep or sidewalk it as well. And we're going to go into more about this later because there are some advantages, disadvantages of using tag crash. Mm-hmm. So we'll get into that in the next episode. But for now, there you have it. This is one of the, what's another defensive option?
Yeah, like, okay, so basically, let's show them a basic example of what can happen if you just raw tagged rather than using tag crash instead.
Okay.
So I'm on the floor, I decide not to use my tag crash. I'm just gonna raw tag anyways, and law comes in and gets launched again, and then I lose another much percent, you know?
Because basically raw tags are very unsafe in this game.
Yeah, and there are only certain exceptions to that rule where you can kind of make them a little bit safer, but generally you're going to get killed.
Right.
So, in this situation, you could just use a tag crash instead and safely get yourself in and block whatever attack you need to. So let's show them blocking. Yeah, so generally it's safe on block, but the only time it won't be safe is when they create a situation where it whiffs. But that's up to you, and that's also spacing dependent. If they get close to you, you can tag crash. If they're far away, you just safe tag.
Right. So it's all depends on the situation, but it's another tool in your arsenal.
Yes.
Cool. Yeah, wow, that was a good word for those combos, Bob.
That was impressive.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
But, you know, these first two episodes have been really defensive. You know, we've showed you guys a lot of the basics of the game, but it is a tag game, and the new exciting thing is all these cool combos you can do with both your teammates and the team synergy. So getting started next episode, we're going to start getting really offensive. You know, yeah, we're going to get really, really offensive. We're going to talk about the combo system, Red Life, Tag Crash, Netsu Rage, and the Tag Assault system specifically. You know, as well as damage scaling and some other stuff for you hardcore fans out there. Be sure to follow us, youtube.com/levelupyourgame, as well as Twitter, Facebook, and Twitch/levelupyourgame. And other than that about wraps up this episode. So tune in next time to Level Up Your Game.